Hi guys, welcome back to our channel. This morning I'm going to be showing you what I do with Stassi for her daily morning routine, and I do this every single morning. So it's important that if you have a Shih Tzu, or you know, any other breed that has a tendency to tear, or a breed that has like the longer fur by the eyes, it's important that you do a daily routine to keep their faces nice and clean, and so that they don't smell, and so that they look really pretty as well. So I get up a half an hour early every morning to do this routine with Stassi, and it's worth it to me. I love it, and I just love the way she looks. And so in keeping her looking that way, this is something that we definitely have to do. Sometimes I even do this twice a day. It takes me about 30 minutes to do this. So, you know, it is time consuming and it is a commitment, but I love it. So let's move on. So the first thing that I do is I use a grooming pillow, and this is a necessity when you have a breed such as a Shih Tzu or a Maltese or a Yorkie, anything where you're putting top knots in. But it also helps to keep their heads really straight, and when you're doing like the face cleaning and stuff. So I always, you know, just put the pillow on, and then the first thing that I usually start with is brushing her teeth. I find that I have more time in the mornings for this than in the evenings, so I brush her teeth in the mornings. And then also she has just had her breakfast, so it works out really well that we brush the teeth now. So what I do is I keep a bottle of water. This is just a spray bottle that I had, but I fill it up with water and I keep this on the grooming table along with some paper towels. And I take her toothbrush, and this is a CET toothbrush. And I just wet the toothbrush to get it, you know, nice and wet. And then I am using the CET enzymatic toothpaste in the vanilla mint flavor. It's nice if you're doing this to have all of your supplies, you know, at hand so that you don't have to get up and go, you know, different places. So what I do to brush her teeth is I kind of grab her hair that she has like on the side of her mouth. And then I just put the toothbrush in and I start brushing. So I'm kind of holding her mouth open with the sides of her fur. She really likes the taste of this, so it kind of helps, you know, this uncomfortable position for her, because she knows that she's getting something that tastes good. I pay attention to those back, like teeth in the back, because those are the ones that are going to get more tartar than the front. And then I just go all around her mouth with the little toothbrush. And then I do the other side. And hopefully you can see. And then most times I add a little bit more toothpaste to do this other side to make sure that this is getting some of that enzymatic toothpaste. You always want to do this before you clean the face, because, you know, it does get on her fur a little bit. So you can see that she's just like licking it, and she really loves the way it tastes. And then to get the fronts, I kind of just hold her lips open a little bit. Oh, and she's going to fight me this morning. Okay. There we go. There we go. All right. All right. So basically that's it. It only takes a couple of minutes. And then I use my same paper towel to wash her brush. You know, it would be more convenient if I had a little sink right here, but I don't. So this works out really well. She's licking my hand. Okay, so now that her brush is nice and clean, I picked that up. And then the next thing that I'm going to do is brush her. So I am using a Chris Christensen 27 millimeter pen brush to do this. And you always want to brush the coat when it is a little bit damp. So I have a few different products that I use, but I just got this new Royal Treatment Brushless Ultimate Maintenance Spray in from Premium Show Pet Grooming Products. You can buy this at pishpad.com, and I'm really loving the way this smells and is performing on her hair. It has marula oil in it, and you definitely can tell when you are brushing that it does have some sort of oil, but I've been using it now for almost a week, and there is no like buildup or anything, so I'm really loving this one. I also use their detangler and their daily moisturizing spray. So I just kind of mix up a little bit, but lately I've been using this, but you can use any of the three. Those products are mentioned in my favorite grooming products that I just did a video on. So you just spray a little spritz of this spray on the coat, and then I always start with the top first. And just give it a really good brushing.
Oh, you sneezing? You sneezing?
And I tend to do more of a thorough brush out really at nighttime when I'm lying, you know, watching TV or something. I usually do, you know, more of a thorough brush out with the comb. So she's usually not knotted. And then we have this side, so we will spritz it on here. And like I said, it is important that you don't brush a dry coat because it will split the ends. Okay, all right, okay. All right, then I get her ears. So I do both sides, I do her back, her ears, and then I lift this up and get underneath, like by her chin or her chest, and then I stand her up and get the chest part and the front of her legs. Okay, and then for the bottom or the underneath, I do it two different ways. Sometimes I will put her on her side and I will see if she will let me do that. She doesn't really like it up here, you know, being put like on her back. But usually like I can do this while she's lying on my lap when we are brushing at night. But I just kind of, it's okay, it's okay, it's okay, it's okay. Kind of just encourage her that, you know, nothing bad is going to happen. It's okay. And usually once I start brushing her, then she kind of relaxes and realizes that, oh, okay. You see how she just relaxed? It was like, oh, okay, this is what you're going to do. Well, this is not so bad. This is not so bad. It's okay, Mama. It's okay. She doesn't like that. See, so we're still working on that. But that is how you would do it. If your dog will allow you to get the underneath like that when they are on the table. So when she kind of fights me, I don't, you know, I try, I'm doing this every day with her to get her used to it. But when she kind of fights me up here, then I just kind of lift her up. So you can do whatever is easiest for you and your pet. It's just important that you get the underneath of the armpits because that is the area that is definitely going to knot up if you have a long coat. So you want to get underneath those armpits really, really good. So we are just lifting her arms up to do it. And then also right up here by the paws, you want to make sure you get those nice and combed out as well. Another area that does get very knotted is the insides of the legs. So you also want to pay, you know, really good attention to the insides of the legs. And then you would just do the same on the other side. And what I like to do at night, more so in the mornings, is I go through her coat after I brush her at night, just like I did just now. But then I will go through with my comb, and this is a 7.5 inch Chris Christensen butter comb. And I actually will go through the coat just like this, but you see I'm not really hitting any knots. That's because she doesn't have any. But sometimes, you know, when I'm doing a really good brush out, you can brush with the brush, but then when you come back with the comb, you will get some little knots. So it's always good to kind of go back over, especially those problem areas, such as in between the legs and in between the armpits with a comb, because if there's going to be knots, you're going to get it with this comb. Okay, so once we do that brush out, and then I'm just going to kind of fix her a little bit. Well, hello. Okay, so then what we are going to do is just kind of put her straight on her pad. I do have a micro dry bath mat as my pad on the table. I got this from Bed Bath & Beyond, and it is perfect. It's the perfect size. I believe it was a 17 by 24 size, and it is called Micro Dry Bath Mat, Bed Bath & Beyond, and it helps to keep her from slipping on the table. Okay, so then I'm going to take my grooming pillow, and I bought this grooming pillow from a shop on Etsy, and I will leave that in the link below. And the next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to use my little band removal scissors. These scissors have like a little hook on the end. So I don't know if you can see that, but a little hook on the end. And what you want to do is you want to put that hook underneath your rubber band and pull out towards you so that you are not cutting any of the hair, and do a snip. I have a trash can at the bottom of my desk, so that is always very handy, because I, you know, we do get lots of little things that we need to put in there. And then I'm going to do the back section of her top knot with another little snip. All right, so the bands are out. Because I only put her in two top knots at nighttime, with, you know, I take her bow out and I'll just do a quick, you know, rubber band here and a quick rubber band in the back. That's the reason why she just had two. But when I take her down at night, you know, to go before we go to sleep, she usually has four bands in, and I'm going to show you why when I do her top knot. So this is the time where you're going to comb the top of the head and make sure this is free of knots, and then also her ears again. Now this time I am using the little small, let me clean it out. This time I'm using the little small, I think it's a 5 inch butter comb from Chris Christensen. It's the little face comb. I couldn't do without this. I absolutely love it. And you just comb through that hair. Now for this, you know, it gets a little knotty, so I'd like to hold it up by her face, so that I'm not pulling on her, to comb it out a little bit. And then make sure you get underneath the chin. And then we do the other side. Okay, so that is nice and combed out now. And I did want to mention this little area underneath her nose by her lips. This is shaved. So I did do a video showing you how I shave that area. And I usually keep this, I usually do this at least 2 or 3 times a week. So I did it yesterday and I'm noticing I missed a couple of spots. So I'm going to just quickly clean that up a little bit. It's okay. It's okay. Okay. I just missed like a little spot and that was driving me crazy because I am very anal when it comes to this little girl. Yes, I am. Okay. So if you want to see the full video on how you shave this area, I will link that video in the description box below. And it is done for cosmetic purposes because it just looks cleaner and better when they have this little area shaved. But it's also done for cleanliness because, you know, this little area would get wet and, you know, food on it and everything else. So if you keep that area, that little bitty, you know, like 1 inch area clean and shaved, that will help a whole lot. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do is clean her face. And this is the most important part of the daily routine, besides the brushing, I guess. And I am going to use the Show Premium Clarity No Rinse Stain Remover. I absolutely love this product. It is very clean smelling. I love the way it makes her face smell. And then it's not damaging. And the great thing about this is that it cleanses the coat and the skin and it moisturizes it, but it also has and I'm gonna read this, it says a safe grade antibacterial, anti-inflammatory, and antioxidant solution. It breaks down proteins and clears away unwanted bacteria caused by excessive tearing or urine. So this is great to prevent tear stains and it's also great to help remove them. I love this product. It is very, very moisturizing and you will see that it cleans very, very well. Okay, so I keep these little cotton rounds on the desk here and it's just, I bought these like 800 of them on Amazon. And so I just saturate the pad with the solution. And then I start, whoops. And then when they get up, you just put them back down and put them back down again. What's the matter? I think he heard my grandson come in the door, or she heard my grandson come in the door. Okay, so the next thing that we're going to do is then I'm gonna take this hair that comes down from her eyes, and this is the hair that gets wet from her tearing. She is 8 months old and she is still tearing. I am hoping that this is just the teething stage right now. Because she does tear a good bit. So that's why I'm really diligent with this because, you know, I want her face looking pretty and I know some Shih Tzus that have some stinky faces and that is because they are not being cleaned like this every day. Like I said, this is a high maintenance breed. It is not a breed for someone who doesn't have the time or commitment to do this. They're very popular. They're a very popular breed, but boy, they are maintenance. But I love it, so that's why I chose this breed. Okay, so you can see on the pad that I just got like a bunch of gook And, you know, the pad is like sort of brownish. And these little pads sometimes kind of break down a little bit. So I try not to, I'll usually use a few of them every morning. That's why I bought them in bulk.
Lay down. It's okay. It's all right.
All right, so we are just going to do this again on this side. And you don't want to get it in the eye, but you want to go like right up to the eye to make sure if you pull down like right in the corner of the eye, if there are any eye boogers, those are going to come out like that. All right, so we're just going to pass one more time. Usually I will do two passes like on each side, and I just kind of rub back and forth. Getting that area nice and like kind of saturated. Then if she has anything like underneath her chin, I will catch that too. Okay, and then we're going to do the other side. And this side on her, she doesn't tear as much out of this eye. So this side is usually not as bad as the other side. But you just want to get it like really saturated. And you do want to kind of rub. And then we're going to go up by her eye and get any boogers there. And then I put a little bit more. And I want to get this area right in between, like right above her stop. She has a very deep stop. So her little forehead comes out and the stop is the area like above her nose, like the bridge of the nose. And hers goes in pretty deep, if you can see. She does, you know, she did come from a show breeder and she is a little show quality girl, so she has that really deep spot there or stop there because of the conformation of her face, and that makes her look, you know, really pretty. But you have to be very careful if your dog has a deep stop like that, because moisture will like stay in there and cause a yeast infection. So I always clean it because the Clarity is a antibacterial. The next thing that I do is I put her eye drops in, and I am using the NutriVet Eye Rinse for Dogs, and I got this off of Amazon. And she doesn't really like eye drops going into her eyes, so I have learned that the best way to do this is to come from behind her. So what I do is I just talk to her and I come from behind and I drop the drops in the eyes from behind. Yeah, you're a good girl, huh? Yeah. So see, she doesn't mind that because she doesn't really see the bottle coming towards her. It's coming from behind. So that is a trick for putting eye drops in your dog's eyes. Now, I like to do that because that will clear out any kind of debris that she has in her eyes. Any kind of irritation that she has will help with that. And this helps to prevent the tear staining because the eyes won't water as much. Okay, so the next thing that I do after I clean the face is I condition the face. And I am going to use the Show Premium Coat Therapy All-Purpose Leave-In Conditioner. This is a wonderful leave-in conditioner that you can put on a damp coat. And since her hair here is damp, then, you know, it works out really well. This is the product that I believe has really repaired her coat from when I did a little bit of damage on her mustache. And what you do is you just put a little bit in your hands and then you just work it through all of the areas that you just cleaned. So you want to, you know, work that in, and this is a leave-in, so it doesn't get sticky. It's designed to stay in and just moisturize the coat. And that is a very, very important step in this process. So you want to make sure all of that area gets coated with that leave-in conditioner. So once you put your drops in and once you have your face moisturized, then we're going to dry the face. And I am using a Conair 1875 dryer. This one does have the little cool shot button here. And so I will be holding down this button when I am drying her face. So. It's important that you get this area nice and dry. So all of this just takes time for your dog to learn, you know, the grooming process. And then when she lets me, I will take my little comb and kind of comb while I am drying, which helps the drying process. Because you're using cool air, it takes a little bit longer to dry than if you were using, you know, warmer air. But they definitely don't like warm air going in their face, and it can also overheat them. Every now and then I will come off of the button a little bit and just do a tiny bit of warm air just to help speed things up. But the minute she would start to move around, if I was doing that, I would stop because it's not comfortable for them. And, you know, if she's lying here, not moving, then she's comfortable and it feels good. If your dog won't let you comb while you are blow drying, then you can use your fingers to separate the hair. And that will help the drying process along as well. It's important that you keep your dog straight on her grooming pillow and on her table. Because if not, the pillow will like slide all over the place. So if you start to see that happening, then you can just straighten, like widen out the paws and straighten them up, and that will help to keep your pillow where it needs to be. See, her paws are kind of back, so it's not going to hold that pillow.
So now that that is nice and dry, the next thing I'm going to do is just put the hair in place. And you want to not cover up the eye. Okay. And this is always like I look at it and then I pull some more hair here and I pull hair down there just so that the right hair is in the right spot. Where's your eye? Oh, okay, I guess I had too much up there. Okay. So once you have an even line, like across the eyes, you know that all of the hair is where it is supposed to be. And you just comb it down on both sides and then up over the top of the head. The next thing that I do is I use the Show Premium Picture Perfect. And this is a styling and conditioning cream. So not only does it help to keep this hair down, but it also protects and conditions the fur. And it kind of repels the tearing a little bit. So I absolutely love this product. I will say that in the beginning, I didn't like it because I didn't know how I was to use it properly. I was using too much of it. So the way that you do this is you just, it's like a paste. And all I do is I kind of rub my fingers. And I mean, I have just a very little amount on my fingers. And the first part that I do is I put this over on the top of her head, mainly because I want to condition this area, because this is the area that gets all of the bands put in, and you want to keep this area nice and conditioned so that your hair is strong and doesn't get brittle and dry and break. So this is a really good product for that. And then I will come and put a little bit by her eye, and I will just push that hair down. And you see, I still have some on my fingers, and it wasn't very much to begin with. So that is the key to using this product. This jar will probably last me 10 years. I mean, really, because you're not using a whole lot at all. And then I will kind of come over her hair more so, you know, like on the mustache part with this product. So you're just kind of smoothing it out, and make sure that you get the little wicks that come out of the eye that kind of stay wet. Make sure those get coated really well with your Picture Perfect, because that will help to put a coating on that area so that when they tear, that tearing doesn't like get into that fur and cause the staining. All right, so now we are going to put in our top knot. So I am using Ormco orthodontic bands in a 5/16 size, and I get 4 of them out. This is the main size that I use now. I really don't use my quarter inch very much. So I like the 5/16 style. So the next thing after we clean the face is we're gonna do a top knot. You're going to wanna come from the outer corners of the eyes and gather up your hair, and don't put too much in this section. All right, so once you have that area gathered up, you're gonna take the small end of your face comb and you're gonna back tease it a little bit. This is what's going to create a nice, pretty top knot. Then you're gonna go to the front and kind of smooth it over without putting your comb all the way through your hair, but you can see how that stands up like that. That's because that was teased. So you're going to just kind of lightly comb it so that it's nice and neat, and then gather it up again, making sure the eyelashes are not in your top knot hair. No. All right. So you gather that area up, keeping it loose in the front because you want to keep this puff or poof. And then we're going to put this around 3 times. Okay. The next thing that you're going to do is you're going to kind of fan this out, and you're going to take a section from the back, which is kind of like the white section, and as you pull it up, you're going to push your bands down towards the head. So you're pulling and pushing at the same time, and that makes a nice pretty little poof in the front. All right, see that? So it's nice and poofy in the front. And it is, you know, pulled down almost to her scalp there. Then you're going to come behind, and you're not going to go wider than your first banded section. And you're going to take a smaller section. And this section is not going to be very thick at all. Just a very small section. And you're going to pull it up and put this in a band as well. Okay. All right. Next, you're going to place your bow. Next, you're going to place your bow, and I believe we're going to use one of our new doggy bow ties, glitter bows. So this one is in the in-between size. So, oops, I have a little bit of hair from the first knot in the second one. That's okay. We get it out. All right, so we're going to take this, the bands on the back, and I use both of the bands in the back, and I put both of my fingers in there, and then I just slip it, I kind of grab the top knot, and I just slip it over and position the bow underneath those bands. So that goes right underneath the bands. Then I take another 5/16 band, and I band these two sections together. Paying close attention that you're not ruining your poof in the front, so you don't want to pull it tight to where it will make this area go like up, back, you know, like back by her head. And then you're going to kind of position, make sure it is correct. And then you're going to take and do another section. Now, if you have a puppy, you won't need to do this part, because this is just because this is so much hair now. And I know this is going to get a whole lot longer, but you're going to make a pretty deep section. You're going to go back like kind of in a V. And grab up the hair all the way back, like from to the back of her skull, and you're going to get this section, and you are going to band this. And just 2 wraps is good for that. Oops, I need 1 more band. All right. And this is just the way that I've been doing her top knots lately, and they've been coming out pretty. So it's just trial and error. Okay, and then the next thing that you're going to do is then you are going to bring this top, this very back section forward, and then connect all of these together with another band. Okay. And this is the part that makes like that nice little fan, is when you do that back section. That's what makes that nice fan in the back. All right, and then the very last step that we do is we will apply our drying powder. And this is by Paw Marks, and I absolutely love this powder. And this helps to keep the face dry and prevent those tears from soaking into the fur. So it helps prevent the tear staining as well. And I am using just a little cosmetic brush to apply this. And I want to get the areas underneath her eyes, because that is the areas that stay really wet. And then all of the white areas like around her face. Her mustache. I get those areas pretty good, and then I kind of pull this back a little bit and I put some powder right in the stop area, because remember, we want to keep that area nice and dry so that it doesn't accumulate moisture. Okay. All right, you guys, that's it. So that is her morning routine. So we do this every morning. And like I said, sometimes twice a day. It did take me a little bit longer this morning because I was talking and showing, but I am, it doesn't take me that long normally. So I know you're probably thinking, oh my goodness, I'll never have time to do this. But, you know, if you make the time in your day to do this, it really doesn't take long. And then once you start doing it, you know, often, you get really used to doing it, and it gets quicker. And your dog will get very used to it, and she would look so pretty just like Stassi. All right, and then the last thing that we do before we get our treat is I spritz her with her little perfume, because I love the way this Beautifer smells. It is the best little cologne ever for dogs, especially a girl dog, because it smells nice and girly. I think they make the same kind in a boy scent, but I'm not sure what that would be, because I only buy this one, and I buy these like 4 bottles at a time. I love them. This is the Beautifer Pet Perfume. All right, you guys, thank you for watching. As always, leave any questions or comments in the description box below, and we'll see you on the next video.